Support WrestleTalk!
Donate on Patreon.
The Elimination Chamber is happening tomorrow. Like, right as you're listening to this, some poor so-and-so somewhere is meticulously weaving 2 miles of steel into a humongous mesh hellhole. Can you weave steel? It doesn't matter, because someone is doing that, skin ripping from their fingertips, bloodied knuckles as they hoist up this demonic structure, this goth crystal dome. And as the metal rises high above the ring, so too do the rumours surrounding the penultimate pay-per-view before WrestleMania, because despite us talking through all of the rumours surrounding Elimination Chamber last weekend, even more have come to light in the interim. So with that said, I am El Fakador Laurie Blake, and here are the last minute Elimination Chamber rumours that you just need to know. Pay attention. Daniel Bryan to win. Now, Daniel Bryan's going to have to beat the odds this weekend as he takes on 5 other men inside the bouncy castle for the cast of Stomp that is otherwise known as the Elimination Chamber. Now, those 5 men are Samoa Joe, your new favourite wrestler Kofi Kingston, Randy Orton, Jeff Hardy, and AJ Styles, who will all have their eyes on the hemp strap. And that's not just to have a quick rub on it for hemp's anti-inflammatory properties post being flung into the chamber walls. But the rumours are to be believed, ain't nobody gonna be rubbing up on that belt but the champ himself. Because everyone is saying that Bryan is gonna be walking out of the chamber the and still WWE champion. The grammar doesn't work there, but you get what I mean. Betting sites currently have Bryan as the big favourite to win the match with 1-5 odds. Interestingly though, Randy Orton is the second favourite to win at 8-1, and as that's very unlikely, even with him popping out of his pod last after winning the gauntlet on SmackDown, it's probably not a very good omen for the other guys in the match, is it? In descending order, the favourites are Daniel Bryan, Randy Orton, AJ Styles, Samoa Joe, Kofi Kingston, and then Jeff Hardy. Poor old Jeff, can't even climb above the guy who didn't even know he was in the match until Tuesday. Now, giving Bryan the advantage here, of course, is that he does have the hulking ginger-bearded beauty Eric Rowan in his corner, and in all likelihood, he's going to make some kind of intervention to ensure that Bryan comes away with a belt. Because the only hard facts we have about this match is that we currently know that Randy Orton will be entering the chamber last after winning the gauntlet match from out of nowhere. It was the crowd on SmackDown Live. So Bryan is going to have to spend a decent amount of time in the ring before he can triumphantly hold the championship aloft. Thankfully, conserving energy is probably something he's used to nowadays. Thing is though, will Rowan alone be enough to ensure victory for Bryan? Because surely, 3 beards are better than 2. Luke Harper to return. Or just Harper, depending on how lazy the Titantron guys are feeling, I guess. Luke Harper hasn't been seen on WWE TV since last June, following an injury to former Bludgeon brother Eric Rowan, and then a subsequent injury to his own arm. PW Insider reported over last weekend that Harper was cleared to return, and that he may have done at this week's SmackDown Live. Now, as we all know, it didn't happen. But the fact that he was backstage suggests his return could happen at any moment. Now, Rowan returned at the Royal Rumble to help Daniel Bryan win, so why not have Luke Harper return at Elimination Chamber to do the exact same thing? Because Bryan's vegan, eco-friendly stable's looking a little bit thin on the ground with just him and Rowan, but you add in another tall bloke with a beard and a penchant for plaid, you know, a vegan, and you got yourself a bona fide stable. So say that Rowan somehow finds himself kicked from the chamber side like he was during the gauntlet match, Bryan would be all alone, and in that situation someone like Harper could come in and save the day. Although Rowan could just come back out too, to be honest. I don't think there's any disqualifications. But that is too simple. I guess the real question here though is that what happened in the last 6 months to Harper and Rowan to make them swap their mallets for trowels, turning them into plant-loving guardians of the world? I mean, they probably watched that Cowspiracy documentary in their time off. Sasha Banks and Bayley to win. Over the past couple of weeks, WWE has been doing everything possible to convince fans that Sasha Banks is on her deathbed, and that if she walks into the Elimination Chamber, she might not walk out again. Banks has actually been cleared to wrestle for some time, but WWE seem quite keen on the story that she is hurt and will therefore be a burden on her partner Bailey in the match, much to Graves' elation, I imagine. So much so that they said that she had re-aggravated a shoulder injury on Raw this week and said that she may not be able to compete in the Chamber match, and then they very quickly had to walk that one backwards and say that she was cleared. Now, I don't know if there was genuinely something up and she was checked and then cleared, or maybe they just realised that saying your biggest draw in the match might not be in the match is a terrible idea, and even if it gets you babyface sympathy, considering the tickets out of the way. Now, Boss Hug lost the triple threat tag match this week on Raw, which means they'll be entering first alongside Sonya Deville and Mandy Rose. Fire and Desire, hot and hot, who lost their corresponding match on SmackDown. And despite all of this, the betting sites have Banks and Bayley as the clear favourites. Without slating anyone else in the match, they are by far and away the most talented pair in the Chamber. And if WWE does want to make the women's tag division feel believable, to me, there's no one else that they could really make the champions. Nia Jax would be the other obvious choice, being a genuine source of legitimate heat. And unlike Mandy Rose, that heat is not just in Graves' crotch. But then Nia is currently teamed with Tamina, the literal opposite of heat, frozen, and not in a cute let it go way. She's not a bit of a fixer-upper, she just never gets any better. And that's why you don't want them with the belts. So while the women's tag division is still in its infancy, there needs to be a pair that can put on believable title defenses against all comers from across all of WWE, and Sasha and Bayley are clearly it. Because like it's said to be happening, if the belts are to be defended across all of the brands, there's plenty of potential teams for them to face down the line. And with tag teams really starting to blossom in NXT and really good people in NXT UK, it could be in for some really good matches in the future. No titles to change hands. Now, before you start moaning, the women's tag titles don't actually belong to anyone's hands, and therefore they can't change hands. If anything, they are just gaining hands. According to Cageside Seats, though, other than the aforementioned women's tag belts, no other championships are expected to change hands at Elimination Chamber, which means that Ruby Riott, Finn Balor, the Usos, and everyone in the men's Elimination Chamber, let's just take the night off. Now, it's not all that hard to see the logic behind this one, because Ronda obviously isn't going to suddenly drop her Raw women's title to Ruby Riott just 2 months before WrestleMania and that match with Becky, Charlotte, wink. And The Miz and Shane, they're doing great things on SmackDown Live, and WWE are focused on burying Finn Balor, so he ain't winning nothing, though I predicted he would, and I totally regret it now. And Bryan will almost certainly be holding onto his title until WrestleMania, so he can drop it on the biggest stage of them all to whoever is the biggest babyface by that point. Hopefully, Mustafa Ali, for my money. Now, I know I just said that, and there are, of course, always exceptions and surprises. It is, however, unusual for titles to change hands in the last few months before WrestleMania, as WWE like to save any big plan changes for the biggest show of the year. It just makes sense. But I got my fingers crossed for the Wrestle League predictions that the Intercontinental title does actually switch at Elimination Chamber, because it's not like it's been treated well recently, so what's a little more harm to it gonna do? Samoa Joe will be screwed. Samoa Joe is hardly a sympathetic figure, what with his tendency to choke people from behind or break into people's houses, shout Wendy in the middle of the night. But that doesn't mean that people can't be mean to him as well. After all, there is a reason that people bully, because someone backstage told them to do it. So here's the thing, the next thing I say could be a spoiler. So if you don't want to know what it is, I don't know why you clicked a video that is all about potential spoilers. If you don't want to know, you're going to have to skip ahead. Local advertising for Fastlane, the pay-per-view that comes after Elimination Chamber, currently lists one of the matches as Daniel Bryan, who is still the champion, versus AJ Styles and Samoa Joe. Does this mean that Samoa Joe will come very close to winning at the Elimination Chamber, only to be screwed out of it? I'm not saying they're going to be turning Joe face, because that would just be dumb, but say he's got Brian the Kikina Clutch, for example, and is then beaten up by Rowan, he would have a genuine reason to be upset. Unlike normal, where he's just upset and no reason. And because very few people in WWE can cut a promo quite like Joe, it would then be perfectly logical that he would come out on Tuesday night to explain that he was screwed out of his opportunity and therefore demand a rematch at Fastlane. But you're asking, how does AJ Styles get into the match? Well, he's just going to be feuding with Daniel Bryan forever, so he'll be in the match because I guess it just wouldn't feel right if he wasn't. He's like Charlotte, he'll just make his way in. Even with that little tidbit of information, we're actually no closer to knowing who we're battling for the WWE Championship at WrestleMania. But could this be the start of a Joe versus Brian feud. The biggest heel versus the smallest carbon footprint. The women's chamber to main event. The women's elimination chamber will see the crowning of the inaugural WWE Women's Tag Team Champions. And although it's unlikely to be the match of the night, due to it being a completely unwieldy match to put on and the number of bodies that are going to be involved in it. The rumour plan, though, is that the Women's Chamber will be the main event of the show. Much like the first ever Women's Royal Rumble and the first ever Women's Hell in a Cell match, WWE likes to put these things on last because it makes it seem like a much bigger deal and they can pretend that they care. Basically, if you want a women's match to go on last, you just shove first ever in front of it and that should do the trick. It's like the first ever Jimmy Uso on a pole match between Naomi and Mandy Rose, the main event Fastlane then. In the case of this year's Women's Chamber match, it helps that these are brand new titles. So finishing the show with them being held aloft is a brilliant PR move in itself. And as long as it's someone the crowd actually want to win, who's gonna complain? Who am I kidding? Someone's going to complain. It's 2019, which is not even as good. It's not even as good as 2018, is it? 2018 was great. And 2017. 2017 was the best. We had The Get Out, that came out in the cinema. Ed Sheeran, he did Galway Girl. She played a fiddle in an Irish beer and I heard her in my head. Pretty little Galway Girl. But those are just rumours hinting at who might win the matches at Elimination Chamber. But forget all of that, and why not watch a bunch of people just guess at random about who might win? Those people are obviously me, Ollie and Luke, as we try to predict the outcome of Elimination Chamber in the video that is on screen now. Click it, watch it, love it, love you, thank you. And give us a subscribe to stay up to date on all of the latest wrestling news. I've been El Fakador, and that was Lucha.